Every website wants to rank in the Google's featured snippets. But the question is, how do you do that? In this video, I'm going to answer that question. I'm going to tell you how to rank in Google's featured snippets and also a lot of different rich results, which can give you an edge in the search results. Let's talk about them step by step. So the first kind of snippet you can aim to rank for in the Google search results is something like this. Beautiful snippet appearing on, or I say before the first result, which ensures that the first website ranking for the snippet attracts the majority of the clicks. And that's one of the reasons you should aim for to rank here, right here in the snippets. So you see right here, the question has been answered. Whatever question I asked has been answered here. So there are a few different things you can do to ensure that the website has the maximum probability to, as I achieve this, or I say rank in the snippet here. So the first thing you should ensure is that your website has high quality original content and also has a lot of authority. New websites which just start out or don't have much content won't be rewarded by Google in the snippets with this kind of result. You need to have some sort of authority. You should have some, I'd say, age on your website and also have some authority. That means links coming in, high quality or history of high quality content. Make sure the website is indexed by Google for a long time and it's been updated frequently with up-to-date information. This ensures that Google understands and trusts your website with the information that it decides to show here. So these are the basic things that you need to have first. And on the post itself or on the content itself, there are a few different things you can do. First of all, even though whatever the question is, whatever the post is about, make sure that you include some pieces of content, maybe a few different paragraphs, where you're trying to answer the question specifically, or I'd say in a way that can be directly picked up by Google. For example, how to lose weight at home without strat diets and going. This entire post, or from the title, I can ensure that this entire post is about how to go or how to lose weight without crash diets. But if this was a post about how to lose weight, they could have included a paragraph which could have said how to lose weight without crash diet. This is how you include the specific kind of questions inside your post itself, where Google can pick up the question and directly display them in the search results. So here's how to do it. When you're writing the post, whatever your content is, if you've seen or if you have already understood that, hey, Google might use this as a snippet, then make sure to include a couple of paragraphs answering specific questions. And to increase the chances of you appearing in the search results for these kind of questions, you should also include them as FAQs. For example, if you see right here, this entire post is a kind of an FAQ, frequently asked questions about dieting. So what you can do or what you should do is include these questions as frequently asked questions, not only in the content, but also in the metadata or the schema. For example, if I just do it right here, if I just add some content here, imagine that there's a lot of content here. Now I want to answer the specific questions. How do I do that? Well, I'm using a product called All-in-One SEO, which is an SEO plugin. And what it allows me to do is add these FAQs right inside the WordPress editor. So I can just add an FAQ block here and it'll give me this interface where I can write the question. So I'll write the question, how to lose weight without crash diets. And then I can write the answer right here. And this will be picked up not only on the post itself, that means the users will be able to read it, but it will also be added as a metadata or schema to the post itself. And this increases chances of you appearing in not only this kind of snippet, but also in frequently asked questions or people also asked somewhere here. So make sure to have all these questions answered in FAQs as well. And what you should also do is include the relevant metadata about the post also as schema. For example, what I've done is I've written the blog post, I've added FAQs here, but what about the post? What is the information about the post that I can give Google so that they can understand or Google can understand that, hey, this is what the post is about. I should add some schema here. For example, inside All-in-One SEO, you can generate the schema about any post very simply. So as you can see on the screen, All-in-One SEO is giving me some options to choose the kind of schema I can add on the post itself. Right now, it's giving me the default option for adding the article schema, which is what the post is about. If I click the Generate Schema button, I have the option of not adding just the article schema, but different schemas as well, because one single article can also mention a product, it can also be a how-to, it can also be an FAQ. So I can add multiple different schemas on a single post. So whatever schemas you feel are relevant for the post, you should add them on the screen. Or also add them to the post. So right now I'm adding the article right here, but you can also add other types of schema. So already everything is set up for me by default right here. Everything is included here. I just have to click the add schema button and this schema will be added as metadata to the post. And this will help Google understand what the post is about and also give the FAQ schema, which will help you ensure that your post or your website has the maximum chances of ranking in the snippets. So that's about how to rank in this kind of snippets. Let's also talk about some other kinds of snippets you can aim to rank for. The second kind of snippet you can aim to rank for in the search results is when you have products on your website or you're selling products on your website. In that case, you can aim for a result like this. This is a rich result, or it's also called rich results for products. And there are a few different things different about this result than the other results. In product results, if you have rich results, you also show up with an image. You also see ratings, also see reviews, also pricing and stock information. Other metadata also shows up alongside the product. Here's how to make sure that your website has enough data, or your website has the right data, so that Google can actually pick it up and show it on your website. So inside my WooCommerce website, this is just an example. If you create a product and you add all the data, for example, I'm adding the SKU here, I'm adding the pricing information, all of that is added. If you have all-in-one SEO installed, which I am using, so I'm going to demonstrate using that, all I have to do is just use this schema option. So inside all-in-one SEO settings, I'll go to schema option. It's automatically detecting that I'm creating a product, so it will select the product schema, and I'll just click generate schema, and I'll just select the product schema, and I'll just instantly create the schema. And what will all-in-one SEO do is take all the information I've added to the product. For example, if I go here, you see I have the pricing information added, I have the inventory added, I have the images, or I'll add the feature image. It'll take everything and add it to the schema directly, which then Google can pick up and show in the rich results. Also, what will happen is if you have reviews coming in for the product, like for example, if you're selling the product yourself, then all-in-one SEO will also take that reviews and also add it to the metadata. So alongside the product, you'll also see these reviews and all these ratings also come along that. So by adding all this information alongside your product, you can ensure that Google has a high probability of ranking your website with rich results in Google search results when it comes to products. That's the second one. Let's also talk about a few different others. The next kind of snippet you can aim to rank for is the local business snippet, which you see on the screen here. I just made a search for dentist in Florence, Alabama, and I'm presented with some results. You should aim for ranking these results for maximum traffic. And apart from just the names of the business, I'm seeing some additional information here. I'm seeing the name of the business, obviously. I'm also seeing the map listing, so where they are located on a map. I'm also seeing the reviews, number of reviews, star ratings, and also like the phone number and their opening hours, because I see it's closed at opens at 8 p.m. or whatever time the business opens. How do you ensure that you rank for these kind of snippets for local business queries in the search results? Well, you do this by adding local business schema on your website or local business metadata on your website. Again, I'm using WordPress and I'm using all-in-one SEO. Let me demonstrate how you can do that. So inside the WordPress dashboard, I have all-in-one SEO installed. I have the local SEO model also installed and activated, which you see right here. And once I'm here, I can do all sorts of local business stuff here. I can ensure, or I can enable multiple location support. So if I have multiple locations, I can have support for that. I can display the business local information everywhere. I can set up opening hours here, which will be visible on the website, or I can ensure that it's visible on the website, but it'll also be added to the metadata where Google can actually read that information. And also, apart from this, I can add the Maps API key so that the location of my business is very accurately displayed, not only on the website as well, but also in the metadata, so that Google can actually understand precisely where my business is located. Apart from this, I can add a lot of business local information as well. So what's my name of business? I can upload the logo here. I can select the type of business, the address, the phone number, information, everything. So every kind of information Google wants about my business, it will have. And then whatever the query is, Google will decide what information it needs to show in the search results right here, so that it can be displayed appropriately to the user. So this is how you ensure that your website has the maximum chances of appearing in the Google local business search. Let's talk about the next one. The next kind of snippet is called the knowledge graph snippet, which you see on the screen here. If you just search for a specific business, if the business is authoritative, it's well known, and it has the appropriate metadata on their site, you can appear, or that business can appear in the knowledge graph. Now, this gives kind of an authority to the business. If you search for a business and Google displays it, or I'd say rewards it with a knowledge graph, automatically the user thinks, hey, this must be a well-established business, otherwise Google wouldn't do this, right? So you see the name of the business, when it was established, the official website, the founder, subsidiaries, and official social media handles. Again, you need to add this as metadata on your website so that Google can actually have the data and then display it in the knowledge graph. How do you do that on WordPress and with all-in-one SEO? Because that's what I'm using. Here's how to do it. Inside all-in-one SEO, go to all-in-one SEO, search appearance. This is the setting you'll open up. And inside this, just scroll to the bottom of the page where you see the knowledge graph option. This is exactly the data you need to fulfill or need to fill so that you can ensure that your website appears in the knowledge graph. So you can add the website name here, alternate website name, person or organization. So you will be doing this on your particular website of that business. So does that website represent a person or organization? What's the phone number, the contact type, and the logo? So all this information which you see right here should be added right here, or should be added as metadata on your website. And this, once you've done this, then you will increase the chances of you appearing as in the knowledge graph once you've added all this data. So let's talk about the other one. So the last kind of snippet you can aim to rank for, I'll combine two of these sections in this one section, is site links, which is this site links here, and also the breadcrumbs, which you see right here. So for site links, what you need to do is just ensure that all of the information about your website is available to Google, which means the structure of your website, the hierarchy of your website, and important sections of your website are highlighted. So make sure that your website submits the sitemap, or you submit the sitemap of website and it's updated regularly. Make sure to highlight the most important pages and give them a higher priority in the sitemap, and also include them in your header. Inside all-in-one SEO, you do have the option of prioritizing certain pages. So if you have an important, let's say a pricing page, a careers page, an about us page, you can ensure that Google gives it more priority in the search results. That is what you should be doing if you want to include those, or let's say increase the probability of them appearing in the site links. For the breadcrumbs, this is very simple. Inside your website, go to all-in-one SEO. I'm using that as an example. I can go to general settings, breadcrumbs, and here I have all the breadcrumb settings that I can configure, and then breadcrumbs will be added to the metadata. And once Google has that information, it'll just start using that information to display the breadcrumbs of that particular website, or let's say particular blog post or page which is appearing in the search results, to display the breadcrumbs. So that's how it works. So I've given you all the information you need to understand and start working towards achieving the snippets in Google search. There are two important things to understand, so don't skip this part. This is very important. The first thing you need to understand, that even if you provide Google with all the information it asks for let's say a product schema or local business schema, even after that, it is up to Google's discretion whether they will include you in any kind of rich results or include your website in snippets. All you have to do, or all you can do, is just make sure that your website is added, or I'd say all the information that Google asks for is added as metadata. Apart from that, you don't have anything else that you can do. If your website is authoritative enough, if there's enough demand for a specific kind of query that you're serving, then Google will pick it up eventually and display your website in the search results. There's no way you can track it apart from just observing the search results. That's the first part. The second part is how to validate that whatever information you've added to your website is actually valid, and there's no other information is what Google looks for a particular kind of rich results or snippet. Well, if you're using all-in-one SEO, as I've demonstrated, then you don't need to worry, because all-in-one SEO ads, or the code is very, very validated. You don't have to worry. But even if, let's say, if you're not using all-in-one SEO, you just want to validate the whatever ad schema or whatever metadata you've added is completely valid, you can use this tool by Google themselves. It's called the Rich Results Testing Tool. I'll include a link in the description of the video. And you have two options to use this as a product or tool. You can add the URL of the page you want to test, or you can add the code snippet. So let's say you're working on a local website, or if you just want to test out a specific JSON code you have created with any kind of online schema generator, you can add them here. Just click the test button and it will validate that whatever information is required for a particular schema. For example, product schemas will ask for different information, product information, local business information, or I say local business schema will ask for different information, knowledge graph schema will ask for different information. So whatever query you're trying to serve, is every information Google asking for served by your website? So this will help you understand if your schema is actually valid. And also it'll give you peace of mind that, hey, everything that Google has asked for, I'm actually providing to Google. So apart from that, there's nothing else I can do. All right. So these are two important considerations you need to have in your mind. Even though everything is in place, it's still up to Google. So all you can do is add the information on your website and then hope for the best. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, then leave it in the comments. Otherwise, like this video, subscribe for more WordPress and awesome tutorials like this one. You're watching Yuvraj from WBeginner. I'll catch you in the next one. Take care.